So I want to talk about each of you separately at first, and then I want to find out how you come to be breaking all the rules. And you know each other, even though you're an author-illustrator team. Usually when I do collaborations, I've got to find two separate headshots and put those together for the show, but not you guys. I was able to find just an entire gallery of photos of the two of you together over different drawing tables. So I want to know how each of you came to the art separately, and then how... you came to know each other and became friends and worked together. And since David, you're the author whose name is on the book first, I'm gonna, I guess, make you the first in the rotation. Then I don't know, maybe we'll change it up. Who knows? But David, what was your first memory of wanting to be an author, and what was your path to publishing your first book?
Boy, I remember back in elementary school, I loved drawing and I loved writing and making up stories. That was all. Art was always my favorite subject at school. And I remember my kindergarten teacher, Miss Gustafson, when all the other kids would have to go on to different activities, Miss Gustafson would let me sit and keep drawing at the table. And at that point, she was always, I already was feeling like an artist at that point, because she gave me the special permission to keep drawing. And I had teachers who would encourage me with my writing. My second grade teacher, Miss Stempfley, she kept a story that I had written in second grade, and she mailed it to me years later when I was an adult. But I remember she would give me extra time to write. And you just cannot overemphasize the importance of teachers and encouraging kids. And I was lucky I had a lot of teachers who encouraged me. So I knew what I wanted to be when I grew up. I wanted to be just like Charles Schultz. I wanted to be a cartoonist. And as I got older, I thought, well, maybe I could illustrate books. So I went to college. I studied art and English. And I knew when I graduated, I would have to make a living at first. So I thought I was going to be an illustrator for Hallmark cards. I thought that would be my perfect job. And I went down to interview at Hallmark cards, and they told me, you can't draw well enough for us. So I thought, well, what is plan B going to be? And
hope they don't sell that card. My Lord, that's devastating.
So I had to go to plan B, and I had to decide what plan B was. And for me, plan B was to become a teacher. I always liked working with kids. And I went to college for a fifth year. I got my teaching degree. I was working as a fourth grade teacher and writing stories and sending them out to magazines. And I had a story I would read to my students every year. And they always said, oh, Mr. LaRochelle, that's a nice story. And then one year, a teacher friend saw that story on my desk. And she said, oh, David, you should try and get this published. And I said, well, someday I want to write a really good story and get it published. And she said, no, this is a good story. And I said, no, I'm going to wait till I write a really, really good story. And she said, no, this is great. And I said, no. But she said, well, could I have a copy of the story to read to my students? And I said, sure. And she did read it to her students, but she did something else. This friend of mine, she called up an editor at a publishing company, and she read the story over the phone to the editor. And the editor probably should have slammed the phone down and said, and ended the conversation there. But the editor said, no, tell that guy to send the story to us. And I did, and that became my very first book. And thank goodness I had that teacher friend who encouraged me, because I'd still be telling myself, someday I'm going to write a really good story. But I was lucky to have Kathy Hawbrick as an encourager in my life. And that, as I said, that was the start of my writing career.
Next editor that comes on this show, I'm going to ask them if they would prefer that authors' friends call them and read their books. that's got to be a one in a million chance that works out.
I'm glad I was that one in a million, Rob. So, lucky me.
How did you find out? Is it the editor contact you, or she said, does she call you up or come to your room and say, now don't be mad, but I've done this thing?
I think it was something like she said, don't be mad, but this editor at our local publishing company wants to see your story. And I said, oh my goodness. So I sent it to the editor, and boy, as you think it's going to be published right away, but we still had many, many revisions to go through before it was published, but it was the start. And it was wonderful because I was still teaching, and as I was working on my revisions, I was reading the story to my fourth graders, and they would give me suggestions on how to make the story better. And now, 30-some years later, when I connect with those fourth graders who are now in their probably 40s themselves, they say, oh, yeah, I remember that story that we helped you write. So they think themselves as co-authors, as they should. You know, their feedback was very instrumental when I was working on the story. And what a good thing for them to see, too, the revising process. It's something we all need to learn.
What was the title, David? Was that The Christmas Guest?
It was, yep, my very first book, A Christmas Guest. And it was dedicated to Kathy Holbrook, that woman who called up the editor. Yeah, she sure deserved to have the book dedicated to her.
She did.
Needs a mention in every book. It sounds like that. That's the most instrumental, most direct help I think I've ever heard an author receive.
Yeah.
And Mike, same question to you. When did you know you wanted to be an illustrator, and what was the process that got you there?
Yeah. So similar to David, as far as, but mine was drawing. Ever since I can remember, I loved to draw. I have three older brothers, and they were all really good at drawing, and you know, I just saw their drawings and I was determined to be as good as they were. So I was always drawing. So there was lots of drawing in our house. And I always knew that I wanted to be an artist or some kind of artist. And when I was a senior in high school, I entered a statewide competition, the Scholastic Art Show, and ended up getting a scholarship to the Savannah College of Art and Design. A pretty good scholarship. Our family was not very wealthy, and art school was not on the table for me, but with this scholarship, I was able to go to Savannah and studied art there. And when I got to school, to college, I just knew I loved to draw. I didn't know what kind of careers were out there, but I was really fortunate because one of the first weeks of college was illustration week. They focused on one major every week. And they had these professional illustrators come in, give presentations about their work. And one of the presentations I went to was a presentation by David Shannon. I'm sure you know who that is, Rob, the Know David books. And he gave a presentation about how he illustrated his first book, How Many Spots Does a Leopard Have? And it just was a lightning bolt moment of just like, wow, you can do that. That's what I want to do. And so that was the moment that I decided I want to be a children's book illustrator. And that was my, like I said, it was very early in my freshman year. So then I majored in illustration. I took lots of children's book classes. And when I graduated, I did really well in college. And I thought this was going to be so easy to send a few samples out to my favorite publishers. And they would be knocking on my door to work with me as an illustrator. Well, it didn't work quite like that. 6 years later, after sending samples of my work to publishers after I graduated, and I would bombard them with samples, Rob. Every month I'd be sending new samples, and I would get great responses from publishers, but it was always, you know, we love your work, but we don't have a story for you at this time. And it was hard. It was, I kind of gave up after a few years, got a job working as an illustrator. And then one day I was looking through my flat files and I went through all those rejection letters that I was getting, and they were so encouraging. They just told me to keep sending samples. And I just said, okay, I'm going to do this. If I had been sending samples the last couple years, I know I would have a book. So that's what I did. I just bombarded them even more so with my samples. And then finally, like I said, 6 years after I graduated, a Random House called me with an early reader called Counting Sheep. And they asked if I would do a sample painting. They had a few other illustrators in mind. So I did a painting, sent it in, and they called me and they said that they wanted me to be the illustrator for that book. And that was Counting Sheep. And I have a copy right here. This was my first book. It came out in 2000, so 21 years ago.
So 6 years of, probably a little bit of self-doubt somewhere along the way. You're thinking that maybe this is just never going to happen. And then you get that call. It is going to happen. What's that moment like for you?
It was an unbelievable moment. I remember I had a terrible cold at the time. And I still was just so happy, and it felt so good. And I was really fortunate because Random House really, they kept me busy as well. So they gave me a couple more books. I met another editor through at a SCBWI conference at Clarion, and she gave me a project, a picture book, Cowboy Sam and Those Confounded Secrets. That was my first, you know, big picture book. So I was into, I had broken into two different publishing companies, and that's when my career kind of started snowballing. And knock on wood, ever since that first call, I haven't been without a contract. So I'm knocking hard on that.
Mike, were you doing any magazine illustration before you got your book contract? Because I know both you and I have worked for magazines like Cricket and Spider and Ladybug. Were you doing that before you got your book contract?
I did, David. That didn't take quite as long. That took about 4 years after I graduated to break into getting in to Spider Magazine and Cricket and Ladybug. So I was doing a lot of children's magazine work, and I think that really helped me develop my style, and that eventually I think helped, you know, obviously get my first book.
Well, that builds a nice reputation for you, right? When you're able to say it to an editor, and you went straight to an editor, you didn't have an agent doing that on your behalf after 6 years, did you? So nope. If you're able to go to them, like, look at all these fantastic, prestigious magazines that would allow me to participate in some of them more than once, that's got to speak well to your ability, not only as an artist, but your ability to be workwithable is not a word, but employable maybe.
Yeah, I definitely think it helped a lot. And a lot of these illustrations I would do for Spider were stories, you know, so they were short stories. So I would have to do a series of illustrations, and, you know, publishers like to see that you can keep a character consistent. So I would do three illustrations for a short story. And I think seeing that work, I think, helped as well.
So I love day jobs for all the authors who are authors and illustrators who are listening to us, who have yet to get their break, that are doing something else and are trying to get there. And obviously, David wins hands down because he was teaching with the kind of friends that will call up editors. So he wins. But for 6 years, what were you doing to keep the lights on until your break came?
Well, my first job after college was at an art supply store. And then shortly after that, I worked there for about a year. And then I was really fortunate. I ended up getting a job at a sculpting studio where I was illustrating things for Disney and Warner Brothers, like little figurines. And for people in the studio, they were sculptors and illustrators. And so it was a great job because everyone that worked there, they were young. They were just out of college, all trying to start their careers. So I met a lot of very good friends, and I met my wife there as well. So she was one of the very talented sculptors that I was illustrating for.
So that sounds like 6 years well spent.
It was.